I'm Country Twang, this is Lil Round, and we are Twang and Round. There's a lot of artists before myself that I look up to. I pull from a lot of different influences growing up. I know there's different kinds of artists. One of my favorite all-time artists is John Fogerty. I consider John Fogerty one of my favorite inspirations as a songwriter and a singer himself because he has a unique voice. You know, there are differences in different artists. You have artists that are trained vocalists and you have artists that have unique voices. And I love the tone and the texture of John Fogerty's voice, so I look up to him.
I'd have to say, you know, Waylon Jennings, you know, hey, because, you know, he kind of worked against the grain. They said, you know, his outlaw ways, you know what I'm saying, wasn't going to work in country music, but he still pushed forward and was kind of a trendsetter, you know. Johnny Cash, you know, I love his chord progression, you know, on the guitar. Really goes well with the style of beats I produce, so definitely both of those guys. You know, I can sit here all day and name some, but, you know, just name a couple, you know that.
Thank God that we're still free.
We have different ways we come up with the songs that we write and produce. I always feel like from a song writing perspective that I'm pulling from a large pool of culture. And I always tell them around all the time that after we record a song, we write it and we record it, and I listen back to it, it's like I was in a whole other place creating that song. And having that outlet and having that way to express myself is my favorite part of songwriting. Because you get to display that emotion and that feeling in telling that story that you're telling in that song. So that's my favorite.
Well, you know, I like making, you know, nothing into something, you know what I'm saying? But I'm more on the beat side of things, you know, making beats out thin air, but it goes the same way with songwriting, you know? So it's just an art form. Music's the base of, you know, all art, you know? So it's pretty much just creating, marking timelines, you know? Especially the digital age, you know, because you really stand on a timeline, you know, it's pretty much here to stay, so. Slicker than Mark, you know. I'd probably say the bands that Warped Tour, you know, it's pretty much crazy, you know. Nobody didn't really know nothing.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah, the bands that Warped Tour, you know, getting there, I mean, it was like, you know, 20,000 people. We had to find production early in the morning. You know, we had to pack drums about 2 miles, you know, so it was crazy. But you.
Oh, my biggest adventure, I would have to say, birth of my children. It's probably the biggest adventure I've ever experienced in my life, to go through that whole array of emotions and you know, seeing your children brought into this world is probably my most favorable and biggest adventure in my life, aside from touring with this guy and making great music with this guy. I've been blessed to be partnered up with.
If we're talking about outside of music, I can, you know, I can kick it up at 30 notches, but you know, that's pretty good though. My favorite thing about life on the road is going through the small towns and finding cool stuff at, you know, little souvenir shops, and, you know, every town's a little different. I definitely like driving more than flying, you know, flying, you miss all that cool stuff, so I like sticking to the road and meeting new people and different cultures and stuff like that. It's pretty awesome.
My favorite part about being on the road is marking a timeline, you know, being out there, like Round said, experiencing culture, different places, being exposed to all the different walks of life that we come into contact with is a huge blessing, because I want to reach people with my music. So being out on the road gives us the experience and to really see it firsthand how our music impacts the people. And, you know, we get to bring it to them where they are on their fronts, and being down there with them in their homes and their places where they're from, and getting to take our art and music to them and seeing it firsthand and seeing their experiences firsthand on the road. So that's my favorite part about being on the road.
Y'all keep grinding, gonna keep on smoking.
Without music, I think we find a world with no art, because I feel that music is the basis of all art forms. Without music, I believe that was the first way that humankind came to express themselves. I think that it had a big part to do with evolution in itself. So without music, we may still be all Neanderthals, if you believe in evolution. So without music, I don't see culture progressing the way it's progressed and grown to be what it is today, and the world that we live in today. It would be a completely different world without music.
Without music, I'd probably be an astronaut, because my head fit in the helmets pretty good. pretty much what he said, you know. He pretty much summed it up, buddy. I love music. I got music, you know, tatted all over me. That's what I do. Well, I don't think, I think you can keep growing and keep learning. I mean, never truly, you know, to see, you know, until your journey's over with, you know, but just want to keep growing, you know, and keep pushing, you know, forward, you know. I mean, as long as I wake up to see another day, I mean, that's success by itself, you know, so that's what I say about that.
My definition of success is being able to wake up every day and do what I want to do, when I want to do it, and how I want to do it. I don't look at success as, you know, wealth or you know, having material things. I look at success as being able to experience life to the fullest. I believe if you can enjoy life.
I never seen a hearse with a trailer hitch. What a
crazy
bush.
Yeah, that's true. Get the party on,
the beat that makes the girls get low. Important, what I've learned, you know, about music, I mean, it carries a huge punch in life. You know, it's really the only thing that ties all cultures together and life together. And I'm really blessed to be a part of it, you know. It's the basis of all art forms, you know. Glad to be a part of it.
Important lesson I've learned is life is short. So, you know, laugh, have good times, because in the end, you know, it's all about the memories we make. So, you know, live it up. Make the best of a short time. Sitting in the stresses of the world, watch them all
drift away. It's my God-given right. Well, I'd have to say my surroundings, you know, just day-to-day stuff. I mean, y'all go back and listen to Granddad Long Legs. You know, it's 300 Granddad Long Legs inside my house. He's scared to death of spiders. You know, it just kind of got born out of nowhere. But definitely, you know, just life experiences, you know, meet new people, vibing from new people, you know.
Definitely life experiences. Taking in everything around us, you know, whether it be seeing how other people live or seeing what that person may feel going through what they go through on a daily basis. Some of the best songs we've ever wrote come from personal experiences and struggles and the struggle of life and the journey of life itself. So experiencing those things and taking them down to the core of what they mean is inspiration for great concepts and great songs. So.
The good thing about where I live at is so far out in the cut. I've only got like three neighbors, so at worst case, I've only got to deal with like 12 of them. But so we'll probably just have to take it to the cave system down there in Kentucky, you know. So I mean, I'll just have to post up in the cave and barricade myself in and just take it from there, you know. That's really the only plan I got. Hope it works.
My plan for zombie apocalypse is what I've always lived by, is becoming totally self-sufficient. Solar panels, fallout shelters, and lots of ammunition and weapons. So, you know, when the lights do go out and the zombies start roaming the earth looking for flesh, all they're going to find my way is ammunition and walls.
So we can combine pairs with his strategy and my strategy, you know. We only got to deal with 12 of them. We're down in the cave system. You got solar panels and ammunition. Yes, it'd be good.
Which a fellow Kentucky boy reached out to us. Said, I got this project that's really neat, and it's gonna be on CMT, and it's a country zombie video.
Country,
yeah, kind of like a country thriller. You guys interested in being like, a part of this? And I was like, absolutely.
Talk to Center. We'll be there.
He got Robert Kurtzman from Nightmare on Elm Street, Friday the 13th fame. I mean, just a legend in the makeup effects world. I sat in a makeup chair for over 2.5 hours becoming the zombie you see in the video via his great techniques and skill. He made me into the zombie that you see on the screen, and it was just amazing to be a part of that. I mean, I was honored because I'm a big horror fan myself, a huge fan of all of the zombie culture that's going on right now. So to be transformed into that, it was not hard to get into character for that role at all.
So y'all go check it out. You know, Sugarland's Christian Bush, Trailer Hitch. Banjo's kicking, bassline bumping while the drum line winning. Favorite drinking. So we just finished up this EP, Pour Another Round. We're on our way to Orlando, Florida to do a promo tour. We're headed to a bunch of other cities down there. You can check everything at twangaround.net. Got everything on there, the videos, the music, the upcoming stuff?
Yeah, Pouring All Around, our new EP, the Southern Promotional Tour. For anything Twang and Round, you can go to twangandround.net. You can tune in to all of our social media, find merchandise, tour dates. All of the links are there, so twangandround.net.
If you want to take it a step further, you've got some mascot too. You can watch his 21-day journey at findmerle.com.
Glad to have him
back.
Merle Van Zandt.